slow and low. That is the tempo. Anyways, you can get more information at mulliganshollow.com if you want to come and visit them here in Grand Haven for a nice low-key visit to ski. But there are plenty of other things that are happening in Grand Haven. Lots of events, actually, John, that are going on here. And so our next guest, Diane Sheridan, is going to tell us more about what's happening in downtown Grand Haven. Diane, welcome to Behind the Mitten.
Thank you. You know, winter is a wonderful time to come to Grand Haven. One thing, you can skip all the lines that we have here in the summer and just enjoy our shops and our restaurants. And we are still open for business. We have Snowmelt in three blocks of our central business district. And so you can walk on snow-free streets and don't have to worry about ice.
That's amazing.
Yeah, we still have more than 20 restaurants open and more than 60 unique boutique shops. So it's a wonderful place to come.
Yeah, I'm glad you said that because that's one thing I love about Grand Haven. You come downtown and a lot of times, unfortunately, you go to the downtown area and a lot of the shops are closed. But you guys have a vibrant downtown. Remember, Amy, when we spent the day here, a day in Grand Haven for M Live?
Mm-hmm.
And we just were amazed at all the little shops downtown.
So many fun things to do here. Yeah. And you just go, you can go literally in and out, in and out, in and out of really unique places. What are some of your favorite shops, Diane, that you love to come to?
This is like choosing your favorite child, know. You know? It's like, okay.
Oh, you can do it.
So give me a variety of things I could see here.
So let's see. We have everything from dog biscuits to diamonds, and I like to share that because I have a dog, and we have this wonderful Must Love Dogs downtown where you can get everything
from
outfits.
Can you get diamonds for the dog?
Actually, yes, I have a beautiful wedding ring that my husband bought me in our downtown jeweler at J. Morgan Limited. So we have everything you can want in downtown.
That's great. So.
Well, some of the shops I think people might be familiar with in the summer, but they all remain open throughout the season, really.
We do have a few seasonal shops. Some of our t-shirt shops and the shops along Chinook Pier are a little more seasonal because those buildings aren't winterized and the winds coming in off the river are horrendous. But the rest of our stores, we have shoe
stores.
But
tolerable.
Tolerable. Diane. Absolutely
horrendous,
tolerable.
But tolerable.
In fact, do you know?
Embrace the winter, Diane.
Do you know, statistics are showing we are now having as many visitors most weekends in the wintertime to come and look at the ice formations and to visit downtown as we have in the summer.
Are
it's
you serious?
Amazing. It's
that
wonderful.
That is amazing. So. But I'm not surprised because I find winter on the lake is just as beautiful as the summer. It's just a completely different animal. I say it over and over. I know I drive John crazy with it, but it truly is a force of nature you have to experience.
It is, and we live in Michigan, so let's embrace the seasons and embrace all four of the seasons.
She's our spokesperson.
You guys have been talking
Diane,
offline here.
Could you tell I prepped her to embrace winter?
Yeah, you prepped her. Embrace winter. It definitely is a beautiful downtown, and I'm glad you mentioned the Snowmelt, too, because I know other communities kind of market that as well, but it's cool. It's cool to be able to do that.
It's very cool. Mm-hmm. I love being able to walk around. We have a lot of folks that come and bring their dogs down, and they just do the loop and walk their dogs in the winter. Mm-hmm. This year, with our annual Winter Fest, we did our pajama run, our sleepwalker run, on the Snowmelt so that people didn't have to worry about ice and snow and slipping. So
it's a
wonderful feature.
So, Diane, what other events are coming up that people can still come and embrace winter here in Grand Haven?
Well, I'm not sure if this is going to be up your alley, but coming up next weekend, February 16th, we have our second annual Hopped Up Home Brew Award ceremony. Like, oh, my goodness.
Who prepped who for this interview, right?
Well, you guys are in boots over there.
And then on Saturday, February 17th, we have our fourth annual Michigan Craft Beer Crawl. So those are events that are kicking off Restaurant Week, which starts on February 16th and will run through the 24th. We have more than 20 restaurants participating, $8 lunches, $15 dinners. It's a great time to come and experience a new chef special that they'll be, you know, maybe test marketing this winter before summer rolls around. Some of our stores that don't serve dinner will do breakfast specials. And some of our places that have a little more boutique-y, like Kilwin's, is offering a special every day of the week. So some fun things happening.
Oh, I love that. Plus plenty of beer.
Plenty of beer. Oh, my goodness.
Plenty of beer.
Plenty of beer.
What happens on that beer crawl?
On that beer crawl, we actually have 12 locations that are participating with 12 different breweries, and we have maps that are available on our website that are also on our social media sites.
And that's downtowngh.com, right?
Downtowngh.com. It's also on Facebook at GH Main Street, and we will be partnering a craft beer with a restaurant or one of our bars.
Mm-hmm.
And so you can see the map and you can walk around. It's from 2 till, till the beer runs out. So you'll see on the poster it says 2 to 6, but that's really when the breweries will have representatives on site. But we don't always need the representatives from the breweries to be here to enjoy beer. So
True.
You can still come all the way through the evening and come to Oddside. Oddside Ales will feature Oddside Brews.
Speaking of Oddside, good transition. Diane, I think you should take over the show because you're doing a great job.
Thank you for coming to Grand Haven.
Well,
we love to promote
so
our community.
Much.
Well, it's our pleasure. Well, Oddside Ales is one of our favorite breweries in Michigan. We love to not only come visit here in Grand Haven, but just flat out drink your beer because it's pretty fantastic.
Well, thank you.
We're not going to lie. So we've got Reed Warber with us, who is the head honcho of the tap room.
That's what you're choosing to call me. I'll take it, I suppose.
You should take it. I'm forcing you to be the head honcho.
That's right.
Here at the tap room in Grand Haven, you guys have a separate production facility where you brew a lot of the beer that gets distributed throughout the state that a lot of people are familiar with, maybe Citra Pale Ale or the Maya Mocha Stout. But the tap room here is a unique spot downtown Grand Haven.
Absolutely. And as you can see, it's always changing around us right now. We're putting up new lights. We just added
the lights.
Thank you.
Yeah.
We just added a fireplace.
You literally just added the fireplace. Literally.
Literally, we watched it go in. I know. I want to go sit by it. But, change is good, and we like to keep it as cozy as possible around here. You'll notice one of the changes we have not made is we have not added TVs. We like to talk about beer. We like to see friendships formed here. We, you know, this is a little community in and of itself in the middle, in the heart of downtown Grand Haven. And we just like to facilitate that, but... We love what we do. We don't do any brewing on site anymore. We do brew about 24 hours a day, 5 days a week, and we now distribute to Ohio, Illinois, Wisconsin, the entire state of Michigan, and looking at some other states in the near future.
You're no joke. That's the thing is you guys are one of the bigger breweries in the state of Michigan.
We take beer seriously.
You do.
Yeah.
But yet you have a super fun attitude about beer because your beers are kind of, a lot of them are a little bit crazily flavored. They're weirdly named. I mean.
Yeah, we like to be a little bit off the wall. That's in the name. It's Oddside Ales. You know, we have fun with it. We try to stay laid back. If you're out at the production facility, which we got to get out there soon, you guys just have to let me know.
Yeah, we've never been there. I've never been there.
Yeah, we can change that for sure. It's ever changing. It's a bunch of fun guys, fun loving guys, just like the people that work down here so hard. They bust their butts, you know, 50, 60 hours a week to put that beer in your glass. So they take pride in it and to facilitate a fine product here. And it's just fun to be on the front lines. It's the best job. So,
all right. Well, we love that. So in honor of Oddside Ales being totally awesome and a mainstay in the Grand Haven community, Reed, can you help us pick
Beer of the week?
I'd be happy to. I've already got them here poured here for you. This is Beer Me. This is an American lager.
I like it. We're all cheers. Cheers. Cheers, cheers everyone. Yes, yes. Woohoo! All right. I love the click.
Sounds good. It sounds really good.
It tastes... It's a lager, you know, and this is a lot of people are transitioning, breweries are transitioning into these lighter, they call them lawnmower beers, where you could have a couple of them and you're not going to be, you know, mowing your lawn crooked or anything. And that's not to say that barrel-aged beers aren't exactly super popular anymore.
Right,
we're also looking at...
Your Mocha barrel-aged is freaking
delicious. Good stuff, but you know, if you have one, two, three of those... Yeah. You're on the ground.
Yeah.
So this is
that.
A session. No, I'm sure. None of us have.
No.
This is very sessionable. It's very crisp. You'll see a lot of other breweries are actually moving towards this direction as well. And why not?
This is kind of your introduction to that kind of sessionable, more approachable, super easy drinking.
More of a traditional style.
This is smooth. It's clear. It's crisp.
It appeals to the masses. And during the summertime, I need to have a beer on like this because some people and it's great. They just find themselves in here. They look through the windows because we're in like a fishbowl if you look around, you know.
Yeah.
And it's, whoa, that place is cool. And I want to have something that appeals to everybody. And a pineapple IPA or a barrel-aged stout doesn't necessarily appeal to everybody. So I like to call this like a transitional style ale. Craft beer doesn't have to be muddy or super cloudy. And it's very approachable.
Very cool.
It is. That's a good beer. No, John, thoughts about that beer?
No, I love it. I mean, I'm getting into the more sessionable beers, and this is a good version of it. Hey, are you guys going to be at Winter Beer Festival coming up?
We are going to be at Winter
February
Beer Fest.
February 23rd and 24th.
We wouldn't miss it.
What's on tap there for you guys?
Are you ready for a list?
I'm ready for a list, yeah.
We've got Nut Bandit, which is an Imperial Brown with hazelnut. Alpha Beta, which is just a crisp, clean, awesome IPA. Double Oak Tipster, which is our hipster brunch, aged in double oak barrels.
Captain
Night, it is. Our Morningwood Stout. Nightman Leaveth, which is an Imperial Milk Stout aged in rye whiskey barrels with vanilla beans. Diggity Dank, because the Dank Cheese series just doesn't want to die out. Beer Me, which we're drinking now. Mm-hmm. Hop Tarts, which is a tart IPA. Peanut Butter Cup Stout. Diane's enjoying a Peanut Butter Cup Stout right now. And our
it tastes just like a Peanut Butter Cup Stout.
Yeah, she's going to.
It's very good. And, after five. Somewhere. And Pineapple IPA, which is just an old hometown favorite. Yeah. So we look forward to it every single year. I did want to mention, too, about the Beer Me. I don't know if we'll have it at Beer Fest, but look for it in stores. We're doing 8-packs for $10.
Oh.
So
that's a great deal.
One of those affordable,
great,
good
sessionable
summer
beer. All right, that's our pick for Beer of the Week. Beer Me from Oddside Ales. Reed, thank you so much for sharing that with
us. Thank you for having us.
All right, Diana, if people want to get more information about coming to Grand Haven for a visit, where do they go?
DowntownGH.com.
I love it. And if people want to get more information about Oddside Ales and maybe where the beers are available, where do they go, Reed?
OddsideAles.com, or you can download our app.
Perfect. All right, John, where are we going to be next week?
We don't know.
But stay tuned to Behind the Mitten to find out.